So I can't believe I'm saying this in a video, but Dianne Feinstein has done nothing wrong. And of course, I'm not talking about her entire career or entire life. I'm talking about this one specific situation, which seems to be going, like, pretty much viral. It's trending on all of social media. The New York Times posted about it. It's referring to a video of Dianne Feinstein lecturing children who want a Green New Deal, as said in the title here. But I'm not going to go specifically through every bit of the article, because that's not what's important. I'll leave a link to this in the description, of course. I'll leave a link to the video in the description. I encourage you to watch it. I encourage you to see what actually happened. I'm not going to play it here because I don't want to get copyright striked again by an organization. But basically what happened was a group called the Sunrise Movement, which encourages young people to combat climate change. They essentially said, like, hey, let's get a bunch of kids together. Let's get a bunch of kids that are part of our organization to go to see Dianne Feinstein, and we're gonna have the kids ask her to support the Green New Deal, to vote for the Green New Deal. That's coming up next week. Again, if you've never heard of the Green New Deal, it's an absolutely atrocious bill. And I'm not saying that because I think climate change is a hoax or anything, or because the climate doesn't change, any of that nonsense. I oppose it because it is ridiculous. It is absolutely impossible to fund. I can't imagine it would possibly get through Congress. It is ridiculously just, it can't happen. It just cannot happen. It is a dumpster fire of a bill. And that's why I'm against it. Now, again, not because of I'm against the environment or because I'm fine with destroying the environment, because it's a horrible bill. But what really happened here was they asked her to support it, and she said, well, like, I don't know if I can really vote for it. We can't afford it. We can't, she basically told the kids, like, I've been doing this for years. I know what works and I know what doesn't. You got to trust me on this. I know how this works, and I don't know if I can do that. And now, you knew what was going to happen. We knew that was going to happen, really. Like, imagine like a bunch of kids are just like, hey, support this bill that will destroy your reputation for being so atrociously bad. And what is she going to say? She's either going to say yeah and then vote for it and it'll destroy her reputation. She'll say yeah and then lie and backstab and not vote for it, which it makes her a liar. Or she's going to do what she did with the kids and just say straight up, like, there are problems with this bill. And you knew that was going to happen. Again, you knew this was made to make her look bad because the Sunrise Movement marched a bunch of kids into a politician's office and confronted her and said, hey, like, do what the kids say. And again, like, I just find that so atrocious. I find that so awful that the Sunrise Movement would do such a thing. Which, it feels so weird, like, saying bad things about the Sunrise Movement because they have such a, like, a bright, shiny name. But really, I've seen all kinds of people commenting on this. I've seen people attacking Dianne Feinstein. I've seen people kind of just sitting back and laughing, saying, this is what happens. Like, look, the left is destroying itself. I've seen that. I've seen all kinds of different things. And sure, like, I can understand most of those views. But the one thing I don't see people saying enough is, wow, like, the Sunrise Movement is a awful, immoral organization. I don't know what, I'd never even heard of them before this, but I'm disgusted by what they did. Because notice exactly what happened here. They couldn't have said, like, how do you push a political message? What you do is you get children and you tell the children all of these things, and then you march them into a politician's office and say, look, like, have the children say something to the politician, then record it. And if they don't do what you say, then if they don't agree with the children, then look at them. Look at this person. They're lecturing a child. Look at how awful they are to these children for disagreeing with these children. And of course, there's some woman that's part of the movement next to the kids who's, of course, like, fueling the whole thing and saying, like, how could you say those things to those kids? Like, what about this? What about this? The kids are saying things like, we're all going to die from climate change in 10 years or 12 years. That kind of thing. I feel so bad for the kids. Like, what is happening here? Those poor kids. Like, do not use kids for a political message. Don't do that. Because I'm thinking back to, like, I'm 22 right now. I'm thinking back to when I was, like, 18, and I know about 10% of what I know now. And I look back to when I was, like, 14, and I'm embarrassed at the things I believed because I knew nothing, and I thought I knew all kinds of stuff. And I'm just thinking, like, I don't know how old the kids were. Probably, like, 10, 12 years old. But just imagine, like kids are not that... I'm sorry to insult children, but children are not experts in political policy at the age of 12. And you can't expect them to be, which means that if you ever see kids in politics, like, young kids talking about political things, that just means there's someone behind the scenes funneling them all this information. And that's like a horrible thing to do. That mean you're taking this ideology, you're promoting this ideology, and you're putting the kid in front of you saying like, hey, don't like it, like attack the kid. And then like, what do you have to do? Like, you either have to say, sorry child, you're wrong, or you have to agree with the child, and because you don't want to look bad like that. Like, I feel bad for Dianne Feinstein here, for Senator Feinstein, because like, what could she have done? A bunch of kids go into your office saying support this atrocious bill, and it's being recorded, and it's like, what are you gonna do? There's no good way out of this. So I'm just appalled at the Sunrise Movement. Like, they're using kids for political propaganda. And I don't care who it is for. Like, I've opposed that before on the right. I can't remember if I ever did a video on that. But anyone, any political ideology, like, don't put your kids into the political realm. It's kind of like, I just can't think of imagining, like, using kids to push an agenda. That's a horrible thing to do. And that's why the Sunrise Movement, I'm not against their message, or, I mean, I actually kind of am, but it's not that I'm upset at them because I disagree with their message. It's more, I'm upset at the fact that they're putting kids in the line of fire there and using that. It's just awful, because if you listen to that video, like, again, the video's in the description. I can't play it here, or it'll get copyright striked. At least it for those watching on YouTube. But really what's happening here is it's just, like, this organization just using kids like that. It's I can't think of it. It bugs me. It annoys me. Like, that's the worst possible thing you can do, is to start using kids. Because if you watch the video, the kids are clearly, like, they don't debate like they're an expert in the position. They're not debating. They're not saying this. They're not saying, well, what about, like, they're not an expert. It's not like they're some kind of debate club or anything. They're kids that are clearly been fed certain lines. They clearly have, like, I don't know if they have note cards. I didn't see any note cards, but they're clearly kids that have been said, okay, here's 10 different things to say and keep saying. Like, here's the 10 different things you want to say to politicians to get your way. And it's like, that's awful. No, you can tell the kids are just reciting what they've been told. And that's horrible. Like, that's now on video. Like, what are the kids going to think in 15 years from now? I don't know. It's something, like, if there's one thing I'm gonna get offended about and complain about on the internet, it's this. Messing with kids like that's horrible. And I don't think people are taking the moment to realize they're focusing on the politics of it. But again, think of I can't believe I'm saying this, think of the children, for real. That's going to be permanently stained in my mind for the Sunrise Movement. If you're going to oppose or say bad things about the Sunrise Movement, point out the kids thing. Like, point out the fact that they're using kids as political pawns, because I think that immediately disqualifies anyone from having, like, any argument about anything ever, is when you hide behind children to get your way. But, yeah, that's pretty much the whole point in this video, was just to say, like, do people realize how awful this is, and make sure the world is aware of what is happening here? Like, make sure to point that out, because I don't think people have really noticed. Maybe they haven't, they don't care. But I just don't know. I don't see that enough, and I think we should see that more. I think we should see that more of those comments on social media. Like, you are using kids as political pawns here. Forget the climate change debate. Forget what Dianne Feinstein said. Like, kids as political pawns. That is the worst thing here. Yeah, that's pretty much it. If you agree with me, leave a like. If you disagree with me, leave a like anyway. Helps me out. Subscribe for more. Share this video around if you find it interesting and worthwhile to share. That's very much appreciated. And thanks for watching.